The best thing is not to leave the multi-unit exposed because you can see the height of the bone. It's a little bit easier. Hi, welcome back to Uniqa Dental Show, where we discuss interesting cases and new procedures in the field of dentistry. Don't forget to leave a like, share, subscribe, follow us, and send us your interesting cases so we can view them. With us today, as always, and because of quarantine, is Dr. Yaniv.
Hi, how are you doing?
Give it here. So, what did you bring for us today?
Yeah, today I want to show some inflammation around the implants, around the crowns, and how you need to maintain it as a dentist. As a doctor, you take the crown, see, clean, do everything around these crowns.
You're talking about these two, right?
Yeah. In these two crowns, you can see it's a bridge of two implants. You can see the inflammation in the gingiva. You can see it swallow a little bit. It's the color of it, it's red. It's not picklish like here. What we want to do is a little maintenance for the gingiva, for the crowns, to return it to a good condition and move from there.
What is the easiest way to do this?
The easiest way is to take off the crowns, clean it a little bit with a brush, leave it like that for about a week or two for it to heal by itself, then clean the crowns and put them back in.
In the meantime, she would be without crowns?
Yeah, in the meantime, this...
The implant will be exposed? Not the implant, the multi-unit will be exposed?
Yeah, you can switch from multi-unit to healing cap. You can... assemble a healing cap on top of the multi-unit. The best thing is not to leave the multi-unit exposed because you have a thread in the multi-unit, and if some food or residues of something will go into the thread, they can harm the thread, and then you'll have a problem inserting back these crowns.
So this is only in screw retained. In cemented, you cannot perform this.
You can, but in cemented, you have a problem. You are afraid taking off the crowns because if the crown sits very good, you will maybe have to break the bridge to remove the crowns. You can't be sure that you'll be able to remove the crowns right away. In extreme cases, without breaking them, you need to make a hole inside the crown, but then you go back to the... It's like screw retained. Mm-hmm. It's the same. And you need to blindly search for the screw so you can have a huge screw channel by the end of this process when you're looking for the screw channel.
This CT slides, you perform a CT to see if there is bone absorption?
Yeah, the patient underwent a CT x-ray. So you can see both of the implants, you can see the multi-units, the height of the multi-units. This is a smaller multi-unit, this is a little bit larger multi-unit. You can see two crowns. Approximately see that between the implants there is some bone resorption, but still the implants are in the bone. You don't have this big problem. You don't need to take out the implants, you don't need to do any extreme procedures. You just need to take off the crowns, you need to clean this area, and you need to put back the crowns.
So perform an x-ray to see if you need to take the implants out.
To see the condition of the bone, to see the condition of the implant, you can check with the probing, you can see the depth of the pockets around the implant, but an x-ray is always best because you can see the height of the bone. You can see if there is a big recessions or some other problems, because if you lost all of the bone and you have like 1 millimeter in the end of the implant, you can clean it up, but in about a couple of months, you have the same problem, and it will be much worse.
This is after you took the crowns out, right?
Yeah, you can see in this slide the multi-units without the crowns. Mm-hmm. Here you can see the crowns, and here you can see healing caps on top of the multi-units.
I see that the multi-unit is inside the gingiva. Why it's not on the gingiva line?
This is the inflammation that you see. Probably the multi-unit that was chosen a couple of years ago was on with one height of with the gingiva. But with the inflammation, the gingiva is swollen, the gingiva is larger than it was. It went on top of the crowns. The crowns shaped the inflamed gingiva around the multi-unit, and you can see the height of the multi-unit is practically inside the gingiva, inside like 3 millimeters. It's so, a lot.
Yeah, it was inflamed for a long time.
Yeah, she came with a problem of the inflammation. It was inflamed around a couple of weeks, maybe months, maybe even a year or more. In here, we just took off the crowns. You can see the crowns. You need to clean out the crowns.
You just screwed them out?
Yeah, just screw them out. This is the greatest part of screw retain restorations, when you don't need to break anything, you don't need to apply force, you don't need to do anything. You can take everything out and you can insert it back the same way it was. And you have the same occlusion, you have the same everything. In here, you just take off the crowns. Later on, when it healed, when the gingiva looks fine, you just put them back in.
Easy, as you say, just screw it out, wait for a couple of weeks for the inflammation.
It's a procedure of a couple of minutes, maybe 10 minutes it takes to take out the crowns, put healing caps. Wait for about a month, for example.
And then just screw it back in.
Then just put it back in.
Without another scan, without...
No, you don't need a scan because you have the bridge. You don't need to change the bridge. If you have a very big recession and you want to change the height of the multi-unit, for example, you want to make this restoration from the beginning, you can take impressions, you can do everything. But the question is if you can see it, does the patient have a problem with the inflammation, that's all, or she has some aesthetical problems.
In cement restoration, you would have to break the bridge.
No, you can try to take it out easily without breaking anything. But sometimes it's a problem because if you have very parallel abutments and the height of the abutment is large enough, you have very retentive restoration. It will hold very strong and you'll have a problem getting it out or releasing it from the abutments. It can be quite a problem. You're not sure if you can take it out. For example, if you have a screw loosening in cement restoration, it's the same. You're not sure if you can take out the crowns or just leave it there, or what you need to do, and if you'll be able to return the same restoration as it was before.
So screw retain restoration is much easier to maintain in the long run.
Yeah, in the long run, there are places that makes screw retain restoration, and every half a year, they take them out, they clean everything and put them back in every year. Mm-hmm. So in cement restoration, if it's all on four, all on six, it's a problem. You can take it out once, twice. I'm not sure that in the long run, in 10, 20 years, you can always take it out and put it back in.
Without breaking the bridge.
Without breaking it, because it can be very fragile. The bridge is very long. It's very fragile.
We always mention that screw retain restoration is easy to fix, easy to maintain, and easy to use. But if you have only two multi-units here, won't it screw off?
You can have screw loosening in multi-units. You can have a screw breakage, but you have it also in cement restoration. There are pros and cons in cemented restoration and screw retain restoration. Cemented restoration, it's a little bit easier to make everything because you have spacer between the abutment and between the bridge itself or the crown. So if it doesn't fit or you have any problem, you just can take a little bit of the crown, you can check where it doesn't fit, and you can try to correct it. In the worst case scenario, you use a little bit more cement and everything fits. You'll have a passive fit. But in screw retain restoration, you need to have everything correctly. You need to have everything rigid. You need to have everything as much precise as possible. Because if you have some small unalignment, you'll have a problem with the screws. You can have a screw loosening, screw breakage. But on the other hand, if you have in the long run some problems with the restoration and you did the restoration good, you have passive fit, you have everything that you need, it's very easy to maintain, it's very easy to remove, to put back in. a lot of issues you don't have with the screw retained restoration. It's probably a little harder to make in the first place, but in the long run, it's a much more reliable restoration.
In the long run, better use screw retained.
Yeah, you always want to go to the long run. That's why the world of dentistry moving to the screw retained restoration, you have better machines, you have better scanners, the procedures itself starting to be more and more precise. So it's easier to make a precise screw retained restoration.
Healing cups.
Yeah. Here. In here you can see...
Oh, this is after the healing.
Yeah, right? This is after the healing process. You can see the gingiva, the color of the gingiva. You can see it's a little bit of a pinkish white. You can see the height of the multi-units. The height of the multi-units is probably the same as it was before. This one is even above, a little bit above the gingiva. This one is a little bit below, but it's not deep like it was before. In here you can see those two crowns, this bridge mounted back.
The right crown is really small.
Yeah.
Could you use cement here at all in the beginning?
Probably no, because you don't have enough space. For cemented restoration, you need to have 3, 4, 5 millimeters at least, 4 at least, maybe. But you can't if you don't have enough crown space from the gingival line to the height, the highest part of the crown, you can make cement restoration because you'll have a decementation in the process.
This is after you screwed the crowns.
This is before and after. In here you can see the before, you can see the inflamed gingiva. And here you can see the after. Because the healing caps was a little bit smaller in the diameter, when we put it back in the bridge, you can see a little bit of pressure on the gingiva. This pressure will go away in about 1-2 hours. So it doesn't really matter. Yeah.
Oh, that's fine. All this procedure, it looks like it took like 10 minutes to solve this problem.
Yeah, it's very quick to solve this problem. It's a problem that can occur in many cases, in big screw retained bridges and small screw retained bridges. The bigger the space between the crowns and the gingiva, the better the possibilities the patient have to clean below the gingiva, below the bridge, between the bridge and the gingiva, the less the chances this will occur. But it can always...
You recommend taking the bridge off every now and then to clean it?
I believe that if you don't have any problem, you shouldn't do that. But if you can see that there is some kind of inflammation, if you can see that taking out the bridge, cleaning and returning it back will have some positive effect, that I don't see why not.
Thank you for being here today.
You're welcome.
And thank you. Don't forget to like, share, subscribe, follow us. And if you have interesting cases, send them to us. Have a great day and have a great quarantine.
Thank you.